How do you handle essential oil haters? Or if you are a hater, how do you hate less? Well, I'm going to cover just a little bit more about that in this part two video. So stay tuned and don't go anywhere. Hey, this is Lance McGowan with Essential Oils Me. And I get a number of different comments, whether they're constructive or deconstructive, about essential oils. And it's really important for me to be able to have a reasonable response to that, whether somebody likes, believes, or agrees with it or not. For me, it's just important to kind of give something out there that at least provides some more understanding and fact-based information. So I'm going to cover a couple of comments that I have gotten from an individual, and I will provide a future video on that exact comment and my reaction or response to that as well. So stay tuned for that. But I'm going to cover this in the next section.
Hey, this is Lance McGowan with Essential Oils Me, and today we're going to talk about the Essential Oil Haters Part 2. That's right, when I get enough comments, I just kind of help communicate to everyone in this way. So if you are a hater, hopefully this helps you hate less and turn into a helper. And if you've been hated on, at least you can see things from the other person's perspective better and hopefully have a reasonable response. All right, so when we look at the first concept, this is one that just doesn't get even like it's not even on anyone's radar. Nobody really even teaches this, so I'm just bringing it out and bringing it up because it's so important though. It's like foundational, it's like the basis for everything. But it's presuppositions rule the day. What does that mean? Well, the definition of it is to suppose or assume beforehand, to take for granted in advance. In other words, they are right, and anything you say that goes against that is wrong. And so this is really important because we do this and we don't even know we do this. And so there's definitely a lot of, a lack of self-awareness. And I am, probably the biggest one that was guilty of that. And it wasn't until I actually understood this definition and actually researched it and also saw how it came up in my life was I able to kind of communicate it to the way that I do now. Because you can only deal with something if you name it. If you name it, then you can deal with it. And so for me, presuppositions is so important to name, to understand, to appreciate it, to figure out how it works in different, discussions, arguments, whatever it is, and how I'm dealing with people in person or online. And so this is super key. The next thing to keep in mind is how progression works. And so sometimes somebody can go from a hater to a frenemy to a fan, and that's great. I read a quote where it said haters are just fans who haven't been able to admit it yet, right? Because they're watching the content, they're disliking the videos, they're sharing, they're commenting, they're still engaging. And just because somebody disagrees doesn't automatically make them a hater, but at the same time, how they disagree and what they say can make somebody a hater. And I would ultimately look at the criticism that anyone provides as information from another person's perspective. So if it's constructive, then it'll help you improve. If it's deconstructive, it may hurt a little bit, but it can still help you improve, but it's just a little bit harder on the ears or eyes to kind of absorb in because they're being a little bit more harsh, I think, and they don't have as much of a filter, or the respect is lost. And so I still think you can be respectful, but still get your point across, and you can like disagree or agree to disagree, or you can disagree respectfully, which are all skills and take a lot of awareness to do so. But that is part of the personal development process. There's many books, there's many YouTube videos, there's many ways to kind of develop that. I'm just kind of bringing this up first because this is the basis for kind of everything that follows after. All right, so one of the comments that I get is, of course, you're going to say your oils are the best. You're a quote unquote salesperson for the company. All right, so my response is that I believe in service over sales. It's about understanding what people are going through and providing natural solutions when they're ready. And so what I mean by this is typically somebody on the outside looking in will automatically say, you're just trying to sell me something, so of course you're just going to promote all the benefits. Where in reality, I'm not selling, Okay, I educate on benefits and uses and help people when they're ready. And honestly, like if somebody's coming at like that, then they're probably not even open to natural solutions, or they're probably not open to even using essential oils, and they're probably not even open to even learning more about them in like a class format and really taking their health to the next level, because to kind of come at it that way is coming to, I believe, a false conclusion based off of inaccurate information or misperception. And so those are kind of like the three things to always keep in mind when looking at stuff is, do you have all the information? Do you have accurate information? And are you perceiving the information correctly? Now, perception is going to be based off of your own values and beliefs and how you were raised and stuff like that. So I can't control misperceptions. But what I can focus on is giving you accurate information and complete or whole information. And then from there, you can perceive it however you want, right? I mean, again, that's on the individual. But all I can do is the first two things, providing more complete information or as complete as I can find it, and doing my own research, and then providing you with accurate information. Now, how much more that you want depends on how, much of a learner's attitude you have versus how much of a hater's attitude you have, right? So learners don't just look up information that supports their agenda. They look up both sides if they're being objective. A hater will just only find stuff that supports their agenda and just try to slam it on somebody to win, like it's a tennis match. This is not a tennis match with regards to the education that is being provided. It is helping people to move from where they are to where they want to be. It has nothing about winning and losing. It has everything to do with truth and understanding. All right, so the next comment that I get is, do you have any testimonials of how the oils work better than other products? And so this, you may be asking, how does this even sound like a hater comment? Well, I removed the other stuff surrounding it, but basically, they're basically asking like, hey, I already use this or that that may be synthetic or toxic or less quality or, traditional or whatever it is, or, whatever it is. How does essential oils or other products that are natural that have oils in them or whatever it is, are they really better? Like, where's the proof, right? The proof is in the pudding. I don't know why I just said that. But what I do want to say is that, yes, there is many, many testimonials. Once you become a customer, there's a number of private Facebook groups with thousands of testimonials and questions and answers. And so this is a way for people to learn about their products or ask questions and really get people's opinion and their own experiences and testimonials on how the oils or supplements that have been provided that help them. And you may be like, well, I don't want to have to become a customer to learn about testimonials. Well, at the same time, it's like, hey, I'm providing my experience. You have your experience that you can have. And some people are like, well, I need more proof. I need other people's, and it's like, that's fine. You can have that. But at the end of the day, how much information do you need? What is the minimum amount of information you need to make a decision? Like, you have my experience, you have what I've said my other customers have been helped with, and if you have your experience, that should be enough. Like, and then if you have, there's PubMed, where you can just type in, just Google essential oils PubMed or PubMed essential oils, and you'll find tons of research on the effectiveness and on essential oils and how much studies are out there on it. And I know that's kind of outside the scope of this particular question, because it's specifically, they want to know that people have used them and they've worked. I know my sister, one of my sisters is like that. She's like, I don't know. So I would say there's a lack of belief in the effectiveness of the essential oils. And for me, the only way to kind of overcome that is to have your own experience. You can talk about it or you can be about it. You can, and some people are like, well, I don't want to make an investment if I don't know I'm going to get a return. Well, that's with any investment, whether it's financials or stock or other thing. You have to research, who's the, the money manager, the stock, their history, and all that stuff. And once you do that, you make an investment, and over time, you'll get a return on your investment if you don't give up on it and you continue to do your research and understand how it all works. The same thing is true with the oils. Instead of a stock market or mutual fund, it is with essential oils, where it does take an investment of your time and your money, but you will see a return if you do not give up on it. So oils, I like to say they don't help with everything, but they can help with something. And it's about, a little bit of trial and error, a little bit of, just kind of putting in the work to find out what works for, most people. And you do that by understanding the benefits and the uses of each oil and matching that up with what your specific health priorities are and a natural solution. And so that sounds kind of daunting or overwhelming to do individually, but that's why you have to work with somebody you know, like, and trust. And that's why I offer online information as well to people so that they have that as a basis, whether they go with me or not. Like, for me, it's just to help people is my goal. And whether if somebody wants to, you know, take that and actually do something with it, that's what I encourage, because it's better to plan instead of procrastinate, because Murphy's Law will happen when you least expect it. And it's always better to choose something natural that will benefit you than using something synthetic and not natural, because there's always going to be side effects. There's always going to be resistance buildup, and there's going to be some type of liver or kidney toxicity with something synthetic. So even if it works, you don't want that short-term working aspect to overcome the, you know, long-term health, you know, things that can pop up. So that's why it's so important for me to understand both sides, the synthetic side, the natural side, but then also, you know, how it all fits together. And really the key to kind of summarize all this and what binds it together is education. Gotta get that education and that fact-based information. Well, the next steps are to click the links in the description to learn more.
Some very valid points with regards to this individual's comments. And they also had mentioned that just because I disagree with you doesn't make me a hater, Lance. Well, I think a lot of it also has to do with what is being said and how it's being said. And honestly, for me, a hater is just somebody who, I mean, disagree with you, maybe, but I think it's more of a maybe jump to conclusions. I just made that word up or that phrase up. I think it's somebody who just jumps to conclusions and has inaccurate information and then just presents information where it just comes across more deconstructive in nature, even if the intent isn't to harm, hurt, or hinder the other person. But I think a lot of it is around perceptions. And so if it's perceived as an attack, then that's where the hater title can come in. But at the same time, I do try to give people the benefit of the doubt, because I know that 99%, maybe, I'm just making that number up, of people out there who do hate don't consider themselves a hater. And so they're more just like somebody that sees something that rubs them the wrong way, or something that they don't like or agree with, or whatever the reason is. And so I get that. I totally understand that. And so for me, you know, I've hated on people in the past too. So, and I've learned that, you know, I need to communicate, number one, respectfully. Number two, acknowledge the differences in what we believe and agree to disagree at the end. And, you know, whether it's the fact that I need more information or I need accurate information, or I just need to work on my perception of things, there's a number of things I can do individually to help things. But at the end of the day, it is what it is, right? So you can't please everyone, but you can certainly try to let people know where you stand. And once you understand where they stand, you can decide what you want to do with that. And for me, I just want to give more exposure and awareness to my YouTube audience and you on what I go through on a daily basis with regards to people, because it's important that you know what's going on. Like, I am very into being transparent and honest about things and owning stuff that is mine to own, right? But I do want to make sure that things are being handled in a way that you get value out of ultimately. I mean, if it can help you be like, hey, you know what? I like the way he handled that. Maybe that's something that I can adopt now or in the future. Or you can be like, you know what? I don't like Lance because he's bald. Somebody actually made a comment about that. I love people though still. Like, it's great. I love comments. Because really, I mean, at the end of the day, like, criticism is just information from another person's perspective. And that's how I look at it. And so the two things that were mentioned are very valid points. And I address them. And whether somebody wants it, agrees with it, and can take it or leave it. And that goes the same for you or whoever. And I respect that. That's cool. I mean, I don't even agree with everything I say all the time. And I'll say it and I'll be like, wait a minute. You sure about that? Well, it's already out now, too late. So there's no takesies backsies sometimes in real life. But there is online, you can, I guess, delete something, delete a comment, edit a comment. Yeah, there is kind of a redo button. That's kind of cool, I guess, in some regards, but not from a tracking standpoint. All right, anyways, I don't know where this video has gone, but I know where it's going. It's finishing. So thank you so much for watching, and hit the subscribe button to catch more video updates, and click the links in the description box below to continue to get your learn on.